It's that time of year when Aussies vote for their favourite songs of the past 12 months in the hope their pick will be crowned the winner of the Triple J Hottest 100. Now, there are squabbles galore between old school Triple J listeners, you know, the ones who now have property portfolios, wear cargo shorts, and don't think Justin Bieber should even be in the Hottest 100, and current Triple J listeners who have made the Biebs a favourite to win this year. Let's avoid all that stuff and focus on the unlikely contenders. Starting with these legends. The Wiggles, who even after 30 years of gigs, 23 million DVDs, 8 million books and 7 million albums sold, don't scream Hottest 100. But then they did this. A first-class rendition of Tame Impala's Elephant, going viral and reigniting the love of their oldest fans, who coincidentally are now old enough to have their own kids who listen to the Wiggles.
Lockie did a beautiful vocals. Murray had to learn that guitar line, and I had to learn the bass. Emma was on the drums. Jeff came in with the keyboards. We all came together and loved the song. It was a real great experience to learn it because it was so different from Fruit Salad Yummy Yummy or Joni Works With One Hammer.
Bookmakers have the Wiggles odds-on second favourites to take the number one spot.
So many people walking down the street go, oh, I voted for you, it's great. I can't believe we're in it, and I know we probably never will be again, so I'm just enjoying the whole fun.
Now, unless you're one of the 365,000 people who follow her on the gram, you mightn't have seen Abbie Chatfield since her run-in with this guy.
And...
or maybe since she was crowned Queen of the Jungle on I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here. But it turns out Abbie's blistering takedown of some trolling anti-vaxxers in 2021...
I know you do ketamine.
...has been remixed and made into a Hottest 100 contender and the perfect anthem for these strange days.
I know you do ketamine.
I'm hot, funny, smart, successful, independent.
Abbie Chatfield is the brand new host of Hot Nights with Abbie, but she's here now to talk about her earlier work. Abbie, you've been crowned many times in your career, including I'm a Celeb. Where does winning the Hottest 100 sit?
Oh, I can't say it's as big as winning I'm a Celeb because I got an amazing donation to Dementia Australia, but up there, definitely up there.
Would you have ever imagined you'd be up for a song in Hottest 100?
No, I have no musical talent whatsoever, like not even an iota, so I'm pretty shocked it's even a chance. Yeah, it's quite concerning.
If you do win, in your thank you speech, will you thank ketamine?
I will thank ketamine, yep. And I also will thank, of course, Candy Moore, the amazing DJ who remixed my beautiful TikTok.
So how did that collaboration with Candy Moore come about?
He just mixed it. I made a TikTok. He does a lot of different mixes from different political things that are happening in the year, and he made an amazing remix, and I was laughing about it, and then one clip to another, he made a full version, and here we are, the Hottest 100, probably going to get number one. I mean, can't deny it, right?
I am so ignorant. I saw the name Candy Moore and was not expecting that to be a he.
Yeah, no. Yeah, how ignorant.
Sorry.
It's a very vague name.
I mean, I must say I feel a bit intimidated as someone who came fifth in I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here, not first. I don't know if you ever knew I was in that,
Karen. Imagine how much you'd talk about it if you actually won it.
Yeah, we'd talk about it every Monday.
TV was black and white when you were in that.
Abbie had this really interesting tactic. She got one of her friends to tattoo her 1-800 number on her wrist and walk around showing it to people to get them to vote. Maybe I should have done that, Abbie.
Yeah, for sure. It's actually another fan that has it tattooed as well. So there's two people that have vote Abbie, then the phone number. So I've really won there.
The only tattoo I got out of it was Dane Swan's initials on my bicep after making a dumb bet with the owner of a tattoo parlour.
Is this because you want us to ask you to take your top
off
again?
No, I'm not taking my shirt off on air again.
Abbie, I've got a question for you. Are you impressed at Steve Price's ability to always make his questions to our guests about himself?
Not always.
Extremely impressed. Yes, it's amazing. It's a skill for sure.
Well, it is, and you'll need it in radio at night. I've done a bit of nighttime radio. It's a good thing to learn how to do, Abbie, I've got to tell you.
I remember Hot Nights with Pricey.
That's a different kind of show.
Number one in three capital cities, I live in.
Abbie, what can we expect with Hot Nights? You're a pretty saucy lass, and that's why we love you. What have bosses said about from 7 p.m, what are you allowed to talk about and not allowed to talk about?
Yeah, well, I think we're going to focus on broadening the audience, which I think means tone it down a little bit, but not too much. Okay. I think it's, you know, let's keep the Abbie flavour without breaking breaking rules.
Abby, we're going to let you go. Good luck with the brand new show on the Hit Network. And as always, thanks for your time.
Thanks so much.